I don't know why I'm still running. Really? What was that, bro? What the heck? I look back and nobody has a head. Ah, Nuketown. The most lovely survival map of all time. What a absolutely fantastic... Where's Jug? Oh, here's... Oh, that's not Jug. Okay, that's not Jug either. I'm getting kind of worried. Oh my gosh, where is it? I need Jug right now. There it is! Ah, dang it. Come on now. Hello, everyone. It's Stooms, and welcome back to COD Zombies. We are going to talk about Nuketown. That's right. Deep dive into one of the maps of all time. This particular Zombies map gets quite a bad rap. It's a narrow map, hard to survive in, zombies coming at you from everywhere. There's no walls to board up. There's no definite perks. Perks are at random. They'll fall anywhere across the map at random times. There isn't Pack-a-Punch right away, at least, because it drops in along with the perks. And there's just minimal space to survive around in. I mean, yeah, you get claymores. Epic. Woohoo. Claymores. Whoop-de-doo-da. But it's a difficult map. If you're jumping in, you've never played zombies for a while, or you've just never played zombies, and you're just like, well, I'm gonna try Nuketown. That's probably, hopefully you have a friend nearby, because hopefully they talk you out of it. This is not the best thing. However, when you're a bit of a veteran, when you've played COD Zombies for a while, when you've played COD Zombies a lot lately, you're not rusty, Nuketown is pretty nice. It's pretty nice for a survival experience. And we're just gonna talk about how truly quality Nuketown Zombies is. Personally, Nuketown Zombies is one of my favorite survival maps. And here's why. I really don't mind the perk system. Okay, it makes it extra hard to survive. Sure, it's absolutely a thing. You know, if you don't get Jug for a while, it's kind of rough. Round 12, you still don't have Jug. Getting kind of sketchy, you know? And this is BO2, so it's really hard to survive. Let's go! Let's go! But I would like to counter that by saying, what else would happen in this map if it wasn't for the changing perks? In other survival maps, Verrückt. However you pronounce that, I don't know.
Verrückt.
Farm survival, town survival, bus depot. And I guess you could say Kino and, you know, Shinonuma. Those are also survival-ish maps with not a lot else to do. They're just to, you know, to grind and like get as far as you can on the map. You might say that Nuketown is too hard because of the perk system, but I just feel like the perk system is what makes the map unique compared to all the other survival maps on there. There's no other map where you're just surviving, where you have to deal with randomized perks, you know? And I think that adds a special twist. If you've played zombies for a while, you want an extra challenge. You want something to do and you want to survive, but like, you don't want to just sit there and do nothing with nothing regular. Oh, I know where Jug is. I'll go get it next. No, you gotta plan it out. You gotta play it safe until Jug actually shows up. That's quite an epic challenge to me personally. Let's talk about atmosphere. I mean, it's Nuketown. It's not supposed to be that big. It's an iconic multiplayer map. That's what it's based off of. And as far as a zombies iteration, yeah, it's probably less good than a multiplayer map for sure. But like, if you just want to hop on with your bro or your friends or something, like, Nuketown is great just to, like, see how far you can get and see if you get lucky with the box and if you get lucky with the perk spawns. And, I don't know, it just keeps it fresh. It keeps it exciting. The fact that you can't board up any walls and zombies are coming at you from everywhere. That's quite a challenge, but along the same lines, if they didn't keep it that way, I think it would be quite a boring survival map. You know, if you could build up the boards, you'd just be sitting there, you know, doing nothing in Nuketown. Like, okay, great, Nuketown. But, like, there's just nothing really else there. You gotta keep it fresh. You gotta keep it moving with the insanity of the zombies. And, yes, it's super hard. You're running around every corner. My basic belief about zombies in general is that if it's a map where you can sit in a corner and just keep shooting zombies and make it to round 100 easy peasy, that's not a fun zombie map. I would rather die at round 18 having fun challenging myself than waiting around doing boring stuff and saying, oh, I made it to 100 by just sitting in the corner and doing absolutely nothing. It's not fun. That's not fun to me. Challenge yourself. It's okay if you down early. That's kind of the beauty of the map. Alright? That's just my honest opinion about that. I mean, sheesh. You know, as far as an overall map, it's not the greatest thing out there. It doesn't have to be the worst thing, though. You know, just because perks are challenging, you can get Galva Knuckles. That is provided for you, and Pack-a-Punch is in the map. It's not a completely starved map. You just have to wait at certain times to get the things you need, and that adds an extra challenge. And the fact of the matter is it changes every time you play. So there's a lot of replay value to this map. And yeah, if you just want an easy experience, if you just want to make it to high rounds just to say you can, that's good for you, but I don't really appreciate that myself. So yeah, this is my defense of Nuketown Zombies. I know I only covered like two main points, but like, I guess there really isn't a lot to say about this map. It's simple at its core, it's challenging at its core, and if that's what you like, you should play it. I highly recommend it. If you've heard from everyone that this map sucks, I would just give it a try. Definitely get some practice in, you know? Don't give it a review based on a couple of playthroughs of it and call it bad. But it's just a simple survival experience that is very challenging. And we like challenges. I like challenges, personally. I like challenges. And I don't think those challenges are obnoxious, in my opinion. Like, maybe Die Rise, for example. I feel like the challenges on those, there's quite a few obnoxious challenges that aren't even supposed to be challenges, they're just flaws of the map, you know? Nuketown is optimized to just be a challenge. I recommend picking up Nuketown Zombies. Give it a swing, give it a try, and whenever you play, it doesn't take that long to play. That's a nice thing too. If you need to just do a quick zombie round, Nuketown is the perfect opportunity for that. I just really like this map, and I probably will play more of it in the future for sure. I think out of all survival maps, it's my second favorite. I will not reveal what my favorite one is. I'll do a video on that later. And as far as this style of video, I'm not usually doing things like this where I'm just talking about the map and reviewing it, but I'd like to make more videos like this. This is fun. But yeah, I guess that's gonna do it for this video. I just wanted to say a couple of things about how much I like Nuketown Zombies, and I personally think it gets too much hate. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed. I hope you're having a wonderful day, and I hope to see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.